You know, even though the Leafs lost, it was still pretty cool that we got to watch Owen Power's first NHL game.
Yeah, and just wait until he plays against his first NHL team.
Let's go!
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a little ridiculous.
Good boy.
Play all the hits!
Left Toronto Maple Leafs. Let me finish.
How am I supposed to go to bed after watching that?
I'm quite hyped.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Go Leafs, go! Go Leafs, go!
Leafs lose. Woof, Marone! 5-2 to the, guess who? Guess who? You'll never guess. The Buffalo Sabres! Before we talk about that alleged game, have you heard of Betway? I mean, by now I would hope so. Betway is one of the most trusted names in sports betting both in Canada and around the world. And Betway is the sports betting app that puts you, the customer, at the forefront. It's simple, fun, and safe to bet with Betway. With a large selection of betting options in sports as well as strong promotions and fair odds, what are you waiting for? Head on over to Betway and bet your way. You must be 19 years or older to play, and please play responsibly. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is just a lesson in not tempting fate. This is a lesson in not tempting fate. Just a couple videos ago, because I got home extremely late, I did a one-taker LFR video where I basically did my entire reaction video in one take. It ended up being like 5 or 6. It wasn't the rah, 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 rah. That's what jump cuts are like. Ah, bah, 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 bah. It wasn't that style. But I said, hey, lay off me. I don't do these very often. And here I am doing one. But this time, I have an even better excuse. Instead of getting home late from a function, my toddler puked all over the place. All over the place. Including on me. So, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna blatantly look down at my phone as an aid. And we're gonna get through this. And we're gonna do this in opposite order too. Questions. Thoughts on Owen Power's first game? I said it off the top of the video and I'll say it again. Great for the kid that he got into an NHL game in an NHL building. I cannot wait until he goes up against an NHL team. And this is very important. Is it time to maybe respect Buffalo's play on the ice a little more given their recent success and stop always talking about playing down to their level? Ben, that is a great point and I think the truth is somewhere in the middle. The Buffalo Sabres have, well, except for the beginning, I think the Buffalo Sabres, especially their back half since Tuck got in the lineup, Krebs got a little sniff, Tage Thompson won't slow down. We found out he's not a flash in the pan. Jeff Skinner won't slow down. We found out he's not a flash in the pan. I mean, his resurgence isn't a flash in the pan. Craig Anderson is giving them consistent goaltending. The Buffalo Sabres, this back half of the season, have actually been not just a wagon, but a really good story. Oh, Rasmus Dahlin has really emerged this season. Now they got Owen Power in the lineup. Devon Levi is still, like, he's yonks away. Like, this team, the Buffalo Sabres team, you know me. There's a few teams around the NHL. I don't really know what they're doing. They're rebuilding, but it's still a lot of magic beans. Like, look at the Arizona Coyotes. We look at, oh man, they have such a bright future. No, they don't. They have all the draft picks in the world. They first have to hit on those draft picks, draft good players, then they got to develop them and get them into the NHL, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Kevin Adams, who I thought was absolutely hopeless, has put together a really, really good team for the Buffalo Sabres, or at least for the future. The Jack Eichel drama is behind them. They now have 2 first overall picks on the back end. They have a guy who really wants to be there in Tuck. They have found money in Tage Thompson, basically. The list goes on and on. Jeff Skinner is all of a sudden earning his keep. I think it's a really good thing for the Buffalo Sabres. Here's where the playing down to their opponents comes in and all my insults at the Leafs come in. The Leafs have been crushing their opponents over the last little while. Crushing. This was actually their first regulation loss in 2.5 weeks. They haven't lost in regulation since the Habs 2 Saturdays ago. They just beat the Habs this Saturday. It's been weeks. Here's the problem. Leafs are 0-3 since March 1st. The Leafs are 0-3-0 against the Buffalo Sabres. They have lost all 3 games in regulation. 5-1, 5-2, 5-2. Against the rest of the NHL, they are 12-3-2. So to me, this isn't a matter of the Buffalo Sabres, you know, getting the Leafs goat. They have the secret sauce that the Leafs can't figure out. The Leafs in this game shut it down.
They did not try. I'm not trying to insult the Buffalo Sabres. I am directly trying to insult the Toronto Maple Leafs here. Because they're trying to save, obviously, their energy for the opponents that they could run into in the playoffs. We saw how hard they've played against the Florida Panthers in a couple games. They blew one of them, but they won one of them as well. Pittsburgh Penguins, Carolina Hurricanes, the Tampa Bay Lightning. The list goes on. They've done a great job against some of the strongest opponents in the East, but they've shut her down against other teams. They've lost their last three games against the Buffalo Sabres by a combined score of 15-5, I think. They lost both games that they played against the Arizona Coyotes. Like, these guys, they don't get to complain. They don't get to complain. Now, I understand saving it. Sheldon Keefe doesn't look at it that way. This is a banger quote from Mikey Stevens. Sheldon Keefe, games like this are why we're still competing for home ice in the first round. And he's absolutely right. He's absolutely right. This wasn't necessarily the Leafs getting outplayed, although they were definitely outplayed. It was them not showing up at all. And I understand saving it for certain opponents, but my God, please don't do it for a home game. Please don't do it for a home game. This was the most Tuesday night against Buffalo home game I've ever seen. People paid to be there. That's a disgrace. People, man, if you're looking at a late season ticket, you better make sure it's against a potential playoff opponent because you might be lighting your money on fire. You get something early in the season, you get something. Dude, just don't get it in the final few weeks of the season because you never know when there's going to be a night like this where they shut it down. Shut it down. Don't even show up. I watched all the Leafs post-game press conferences and they were all drenched in sweat. From what? From what? You didn't do anything, guys. You didn't do anything. And the reason I'm being so hard on them is the level has been raised. The level has been raised on this team. They are one of the best teams in the NHL. They are a top five team in the NHL. They're competing for home ice in the first round against monsters, actual monsters. They're looking for home ice against the back-to-back reigning Stanley Cup champions or the Boston frickin' Bruins. Imagine having home ice in a series against them. Wouldn't that be lovely? Maybe I'm reading too much into this because a few years ago when the Boston Bruins were like one of the best teams in the league, they lost all four of their matchups against the Detroit Red Wings, who couldn't beat anybody. They couldn't beat traffic that year. Maybe those were their shut it down games. You can't do it at home. I mean, look at this. The Leafs are already down 1-0. This is one of two goals that the Leafs managed to score. Timothy Liljegren, look where he fires it. This thing is going a foot wide. They were lucky to get this one even. With the game tied. You like Ilya Labushkin? I do too. Don't like this though. Don't like any of this. You maybe want to save here from Sjellgren, but my goodness, the gap control. Tage, just have at it, bud. Say, you want to see some stellar defense from the top line of the Leafs? One of the best lines in the league, so I've heard. Oof, Maroon! Look at this! Look at this! Who told you that? It's the third period! It's a one-goal game in the third! Oof! And on most nights, that would be the worst one, but the only reason it's not the worst one in this one is because of this Frankenstein monster! Look at this, is like a minute later, by the way. Look at the Sabres even! Look at their body language! They're not trying! Because they don't have to! Leave a comment down below. Did you go to this game? Did you pay to be at this game? You all deserve a ticket to another game, at very least, if they're not going to give you your money back. What is that? What is that? From Sheldon Keefe, four games this year against this team, all no-shows. So again, to address the Leafs playing down to their opponent versus the Buffalo Sabres are actually good, I think it's the Buffalo Sabres are actually good, so you cannot take a night off against them, or they'll beat you 5-1 or 5-2 or 5-2 again! Awful! That game was a waste of time. It was a waste of everybody's time. I know they're saving it for the playoffs and so on and so forth. You're supposed to be tuning up. The Leafs have a game against the Philadelphia Flyers coming up. They're even worse. Were you going to shut it down against them? Or are you actually going to try? I don't think the Leafs can go a single game. This is what we learned. I don't think the Leafs can go a single game without one of Wayne Simmonds or Kyle Clifford in the lineup. Now, Wayne Simmonds wasn't in the lineup for this one because of an illness. We need someone on the bench to drag them into the fight emotionally, clearly, because they had nothing. They had absolutely no interest in being on the ice in that one. Name something the second line did. Name one thing. What about the third? What about the top line? I saw get some shots. What was a memorable moment from the fourth besides the screenshot of the 4-1 goal that I just showed you? That was a waste of everyone's time. I get needing rest before the playoffs. What a waste. What a waste. Every game for the rest of the season, including the playoffs, has to be better than that, especially for paying fans at home. What do you think? Leave a comment in the comment box down below. Maybe I'm being too harsh. I totally understand. Like, again, you hammer them if they don't show up in the big games. And recently they have. They have to get these points. I'm not saying you have to go 100% against every opponent, but good Lord, you have to be better than that. That was shocking. But again, maybe I'm wrong. Leave a comment in the comment box down below. For now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. I won't make a habit of these one-taker sort of half videos. My kid puked. I'm sorry. Here, I'll make it up to you. We have a brand new Steve Dangle podcast tomorrow. How's that?